Hey guys, this is Ruben, and today I wanted to run you through our newly released wallet called Campfire. We at Firo have been really trying to get a nice user experience. You know, we don't want people's first experience with Firo to be taking several hours to sync up a whole full node wallet. And now we have this Campfire wallet that's both available for desktop, it's available for mobile, both on Android and iOS, and I'm really, really excited to give you a quick run through this wallet. So yeah, let's go ahead. And first of all, you know, we have posted an announcement on this, and you can see that, you know, it's developed in collaboration with CypherStack. So CypherStack is an amazing development and research company that has been really, really helping Firo. And they are also the ones that have created Stack Wallet, which is also a multi-coin wallet that also has full Firo support. Now, Campfire is our Firo-only wallet, which is actually a fork of Stack Wallet. So you see all the internals behind are the same as Stack Wallet, but it's meant to be, you know, more Firo team. There's this, you know, feature with Sparky, and we hope to also introduce more Firo-specific features that are catered to just for Firo, right? So yeah, first of all, you know, if you want to get started, the best place to go is to our website, right? You'll notice that we have deprecated Firo-client, and we are replacing it completely with Campfire Wallet because, well, first of all, it's the default experience that we recommend for most users, and it's available for Windows, Mac, Linux, Android, and iOS. So it's full support for all the major devices that you have. So now that you know how to, you know, get Campfire, you know, of course, you know, we recommend if you doing it on mobile to install it on from Play Store or the iOS App Store. But let's run through the desktop experience, right? Okay, let's go. All right, so this is our Campfire wallet. You know, it features Sparky, our kind of like cute little mascot. So people might ask, you know, what is Sparky? You know, Spark is based on the lantern Spark, right? And we wanted to make it Campfire is all about being cozy and having, you know, warm connections together, right? While protecting your privacy. So let's go ahead and create a wallet in real time. So take a look, all right, you know, it's adding a new wallet. Let's create a new wallet. You can type in like, you know, whatever you want it to call, or you can just roll a dice and let's call this Frantic Spot, right? Most people would have a default options, but you can actually add additional like passphrases, but most people wouldn't need to do it. You can even say, I want a 24 word seed. But let's just stick with the default, which is a 12-word seed with no additional passphrase. So yeah, you know, obviously I'm just creating this wallet to show you guys, you know. So I'm going to just show you the recovery phrase. Obviously, you don't want to do this because whoever controls your recovery phrase controls all your money, right? So let's go take a look, right? It's creating the wallet right now, and it shows all of this, right? So write it down in a piece of paper or somewhere safe, you know. Please don't like post it anywhere on the internet or save it on the cloud. So let's say you've already saved all of this. You just click I save my recovery phrase, and just to make sure that you correctly saved it, it would ask you to, you know, look from your backup. What is the third word here? See, select word number 3. So here it's business, I verify, and bam, you know, my wallet is already created and ready to receive and send Firo. So the process of also like recovering the wallet is the same. And yeah, just take a look at how fast it syncs, right? So remember, a full node Qt reference wallet takes about a couple of hours to sync. So we're opening this well, and now you can take a look at synchronizing here. It usually takes less than a minute to sync. The first sync would take, I would say, less than a minute, but subsequent syncs would only take like a couple of seconds. So let's take a look here. It's still showing 0%. It's not, oh look, before we finish talking, it's all synced up and ready to receive and send, right? You can connect to Tor for additional, hiding your IPs. And you can even specify your own node if you have set up your own Electrum X Firo node. But most people can use the default node. You can rescan, but you don't really have to worry about that if you feel like some of your transactions are potentially missing. But yeah, as you can see, you're up in a couple of seconds. So you will notice that also this Campfire wallet puts Spark as the default way. So all transactions are in default Spark or private transactions. So let's take a look, right? So it defaults to a Spark address, right? Or if you want, you can also, like, let's say if you're withdrawing from an exchange, you can also withdraw to a receive with a transparent address, but the default experience using Spark. So let's take a look, and I'm going to use my other wallet and send like one Firo or something like that. Okay, give me a moment while I send that over. Okay, and yeah, so you will also see from here your Spark balance, your Lelantis balance. So we are transitioning from our previous privacy protocol, so if you have some like old Lelantis coins, it'll be reflected here. Make sure to convert them to Spark as soon as possible, and you have your normal public transparent balance here, but the Spark balance is where you want most of your coins to be, right? So yep. Okay, while we are waiting for the money to receive, right, we can actually refresh and maybe it's already there. You see, yep, synchronized, it's not yet received yet. But let's take a look at the other features while we're waiting for this to go, right? There is an address book, right, that you can add people, you can use like an emoticon to represent them. Okay, you can enter a contact name, Firo, obviously. You can add in a transparent or Spark address here. And yeah, take a look. We've already like created some contacts, just for fun, right? Just for the demo purposes. So yeah, it's really nice. If you take a look at settings, you can do backups. I'm not sure if this is completely working yet, but we are working on getting all features fully available. And support, still goes to Stack Wallet, but you will be able to see all the details of the version and everything right here. So yeah, as you can see, even though it's not confirmed, you already can see that you are receiving one Firo right inside here. It takes really quick. And let's just run through the process of sending, right? So right now you can't because you have to wait for this to confirm. But the process of sending is actually really similar. You can either paste in the address here, or you can just select like here, I want to send to Anwar, and I can add a memo if I want, and that will be reflected. So this is kind of like the really default experience. It is really quick. It does all the complex mathematics in the background. And we are hoping to expand its feature sets, for example, to support masternodes, to support the registration and maintenance of masternodes. But we want a Stack or in Campfire to be the default experience. So this is a quick run through of Campfire Wallet. I hope that you have enjoyed this. And please, if you like what we do, what would really, really help us is that if you actually go when you have downloaded Campfire on the Play Store or on the iOS App Store, to leave a positive review, right? Let me just show you. Right, so we really appreciate positive comments here. Now, Campfire was launched a long time ago with the Lelantis wallet. We are relaunching it with Spark support. So we need the reviews. We want people to be able to trust this wallet. It's still deployed by CypherStack team. And the other one, which we also require your assistance with, is that, the reviews at the moment is because they use an earlier version that did not support Spark, and this is why all the complaints here. So if you really like our work, if you like CypherStack's work, if you like Campfire, make sure to help us with the ratings and reviews. It's free and it really helps the project grow. So yeah, this is it for my quick run through of Campfire. You can actually donate to us if you are wanting to see more features. If you take a look, we have created a crowdfunding proposal here that you can donate money to, right? So make sure that if you would like to accelerate the development of Campfire and you like what you see, we really appreciate any sort of donations you can give that would fund the development for this. So until next time, thank you very much, Firo fam, and let us know what you think about Campfire in the comments. Thank you.